Man, have I been having a hell of a time trying to record this? The camera just does not want to cooperate anymore, and it's getting worse and worse. And I don't want to bring this up because I really hope this is not true, but the camera might be dying. I don't know. I did get it used after all, so I'm gonna hope that's not the case. But I should say, if that is the case, I'm probably gonna, if it does go, either I'm gonna have to put everything on hold to get another replacement, even if it's not as good as this. Or I'm gonna have to pretty much use that other camera I have for everything that's not like recording an actual game. That's gonna suck because while it's not a bad camera, it's not exactly a good one. I figured I might as well mention that now in case that's what happens. Anyway, so everything is gone pretty much. All I have is the Neo Geo now, and I said I was gonna get a GameCube. I did get a GameCube. I did get something else though, which is where most of the money I got from all the stuff I gave in went to, but I can't use it, so I have to take it back. In fact, one of you, old school, actually saw a comment I made to Darren that it didn't work out what I was trying to do. I'm going to talk about this first because I might as well show, because I'm pretty sure some of you might be curious. I'll just go over this real quick before I do the GameCube stuff, and as you see, it says part one. Part two will be tomorrow when I return it and get more GameCube stuff. I was going to use this, which I've been using for this thing. The official PlayStation 2 controller. There's a reason when all these, what it says in the description, Amazon, eBay, whatever, they say only use official PlayStation controller. What they mean, it doesn't mean it could work on the PlayStation controller. What they actually mean is an official Sony-made one. I don't know why, but for whatever it is, these are the only ones that work. I mean, I tried both of these back to back. That thing either has input lag, doesn't work at all, or it doesn't register correctly when it works. The stick works fine. It actually works. If I was to put that in a PlayStation 2, which I have, or an Xbox because it works on both, it would work perfectly fine, but not for what I actually want to use it for. My mistake. I'm probably going to have to go back to the extra KD. I'm probably going to get the one without the trackball because it's cheaper and I really, I can live without it. Trust me. Or I'm just going to stay with the PlayStation 2 controller, and if I do, I'm going to get a red one because I'm tired of not having a red controller or a red console. But anyway, there's that. Hell, I might even get the GameCube adapter and use it on a computer. Why not? Another controller I can use. Anyway, so that's the deal with that. Real quick, I'm going to show you what this arcade stick is. It's big and heavy, so I can't hold it up long, but you'll see what it is. It's not a bad stick. It's not the stick's fault. Here it is. Now, there's actually a story for this. The person who originally bought this, they bought it new. They got it because they were going to become, they had aspirations, which was they probably bad hindsight in their part. They were going to become a professional, I can't use finger quotes right now, Evo tournament fighting game player. You know what I mean? So they bought this stick and they were going to use it, but it turns out they absolutely horrible at fighting games and they gave up and they traded this in. So basically, I paid used price, not real money, what I traded in for a new stick that was never used, but he did open the box. So I paid used price for something that would normally cost a lot of money. And if I was doing something with the PlayStation 2 or Xbox, I would probably keep this because it is a good stick. I'm pretty disappointed. I was hoping this was going to work because it would solve the problems of the X-Arcade thing. So there's the custom artwork there, and I can only hold this for a short time because it's heavy as hell. It's actually got a display thing you can open it, and there's the stick itself. It's got this nice display thing you can put it in. You're not using it. One other thing I should mention is I mentioned I was going to do this. I got Outrun and it came in today. So there you go. Maybe future video, not long from now, me talking about exactly why this game is so special to me. Maybe not. I don't know. Whee! It slid. Now onto the GameCube stuff real quick. I should mention, I actually still have this one game that GrubGun sent me a long while ago now. I didn't keep the memory card, which I should have done. Or Metroid Prime, so I gotta get that again. But I did get these. I'll show you the not interesting game first. I pretty much spent all my money this week too, in advance. I also call the GameCube the James Bond console to make, because there's some really good James Bond games. That's three of them. This one from Russia with Love, Nightfire, and Everything or Nothing. I intentionally left out Age Under Fire because it's not really good. And Rogue Agent, while I like it a lot and it's a fun game, is not really a James Bond game, even though it takes place in the James Bond universe. I'm a huge Bond fan, so whatever. And Sean Connery, without a doubt, is the best. I like Pierce Brosnan a lot. He does a great job. Even Daniel Craig, I've gotten used to, but Sean Connery is the person who defined James Bond. He's pretty much what Ian Fleming's James Bond is supposed to be. Anyway, so there's this. I had a lot of fun with this game. And as I've said before, pretty much anything that was on the Xbox, PlayStation 2, and the GameCube, if it was on all three, I always preferred the GameCube version. I always did, especially with Nightfire. Especially compared to the computer version. Ugh. So yeah, if you've never seen this before, here you go. They actually got real Sean Connery, the actual actor. He does his voice, he reprises in this. He does a good job, but you can tell he's aged some. This is a very fun game. I'm not kidding. It's really good. Worth getting. It's for the GameCube, PlayStation 2, and the Xbox. I say you get it for either any of them. I just like the GameCube version. Obviously, I have the GameCube, so that's what I get it for. Yes, I know I have the chunky PlayStation 2. This is the real winner so far. Although the one I'm going to get tomorrow, the other game, which is also a Nintendo game, that one is, you know, that one is not easy to get either. That's why I got this, that for the price. And also, I don't have a memory card because I tried finding one. I went to 5 places today, nothing. So I don't know what I'm going to do if I can't find a memory card, because I spent my money earlier this weekend. Oh well. I got this because it has 4 games on it, and I really haven't done much with the series, as I mentioned before. So I've been messing around with this. I actually played the demo for the GameCube game on this, which is I might actually make a separate thing talking about that real quick, because I found something very disturbing there. Maybe it's just me, but I'm liking this, even though I know nothing to do in the NES games. Which I'm hoping if someone can tell me what my goal first to do in both of those is, I would appreciate it because I can't figure it out. I got this. 4 games in one. Now, basically, these are taking the cartridge games and putting them on a disc, kind of like the Mario Anniversary thing, although this wasn't done as a ploy. Promotional disc includes 4 classic games. I need to get the rest of that sticker off. By the way, I'm using the S-Video cables I originally got for the Super Nintendo on the GameCube. Looks great. Can't wait to get Resident Evil 4. It's going to look good. Resident Evil 4 is still the best on the GameCube, so it's got the NES, the 2 on the NES, and it has 2 on the N64. All 4 of which I've never played before. And it also has a demo for the GameCube game, which I have heard of but never played. I was playing around with the demo for that, most of all, and they split up into 3 parts. One was Dungeon, Stealth, and then there was Island. I didn't like the Island one, and that's where I found the disturbing thing that I might talk about. Might be funny, but yeah. Real quick consensus of this. I messed around with each of the 4. Well, I didn't mess with this one yet, and I only seen the intro for this, but whatever. I messed around with some of this, most of this disc here. I like it. I mean, I said when I played through the one I ever played, which was on the Super Nintendo, which I don't have anymore now, I liked it, you know. I still don't think of it the same way as a lot of other people do, but I do like it, you know. I'm glad I did get this, so. There's that. The GameCube I got, not really anything that interesting. Just black. I need to clean up a little bit more. Controller, black. So, yeah. I don't know exactly what I'm going to get tomorrow, but that one game probably just really something good. So yeah, that's about it. As you can see, this is part 1. Part 2 will be tomorrow when I get the rest, which will be a lot more than this, probably, maybe, you know, it'll be more than 2 games, let me tell you. So I'm gonna get as many as I can. It also has to be ones I like. Prices there aren't really that good. So thanks for watching, and I will see you next time. Like, if you like it, and if not, then don't. I'll see you tomorrow.